Hi everyone, this is Michael Eilbrock with Diesel Laptops, and today's tech tip video, we are going to go over some more engine testing techniques, just some quick easy tests that you can do to help rule out, you know, engine mechanical issues. So in one of my prior videos that I did, I showed you how to do relative compression with a current clamp and looking at the current. Well, what if after you do the test with your sink and you find a cylinder that's a low contributor? Well, what could be going on? Could you have a problem with your valves not sealing? Could you have leaking rings, a hole in the piston, you know, things like that? Well, here in this video, I'm going to show you how to do some quick tests to help rule out, you know, where the fault lies. Is it in the valve train, the valves? Is it in are you getting excessive pressure into the crankcase? Do you have bad rings? You know, things like that. So we're just gonna do a quick test here and I'm gonna show you what to look for. Okay, so as you can see here, I've already got my scope running, and channel number one in yellow is gonna be my injector current number one. I'm gonna use that as my sink. Channel number two is a piezo sensor. It's a two-wire sensor that changes in voltage in relative to change in pressure. Okay, so it's basically a first look sensor. Okay, and channel three, I'm using a inches of water sensor. It's actually a very good sensor. They're very sensitive. I've got that in the intake. Okay, and then two is going to be channel two, the red trace. I have that sensor, that piezo sensor, in the oil fill tube with a rag wrapped around it to help secure the pulses so I can get good pulses. Okay, then on channel four, the blue, that is a 300 psi transducer that I have teed in to the exhaust gas. It's a pressure sensor that on this Packard, it's the one exhaust gas pressure sensor that is before the turbine of the turbo. All right, so it's going off of that pipe that's right on a centralized location of the exhaust manifold, and that's how I'm going to look at my exhaust pulses. Okay, so I've got that hooked up, and then I have a current clamp around the battery cable so I can look at the starter current as well. All right, so this test, what we're going to do first is we're just going to do a cranking test, and then I'm going to go through the waveforms and show them to you. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and crank over the engine for a little bit, then I'll stop the capture and then I'll explain it to you. Okay. So as you can see here, the white trace, that's the current from the starter motor. So now what we're going to do is we're going to zoom in on the area of the injection, okay? And I'm just going to show some things here to you real quick, and we'll do bit by bit, okay? So now if you look at my green trace here, I'm just going to shut off the other channels here so you can see this better. My green trace is the inches of water sensor that's in the intake manifold. Okay, so what we can do is here to figure out what intake pulse is what, we can go here to our cursors, and I'm just going to line this up with the main injection event here. Then I'm going to go to mark cylinders, firing orders 153624. I'm going to select intake events. I'm going to hit enter. And if I take my cursor and drag this down on the green here, the green trace is the intake pole. The negative pole that you see here, that is the maximum amount of air that's being pulled in from the intake valve. Okay. And if you notice, all of them look relatively even, okay? So all the negative poles look pretty good. Don't see anything extremely abnormal. So this is how you tell if your intake vents are working properly, okay? So, and also what's nice about the inches of water sensor is, since it measures the amount, it's showing here that it's measuring about minus 2 inches of water. Well, if you convert that, you could put it into a vacuum reading if you wanted to, and you could actually have a measurement for the vacuum while it's cranking over. Now, granted, on a diesel engine, you don't have much vacuum in there, okay? But my point is, this sensor is sensitive enough, it can see that, okay? So this is how you look at intake events. So these all look pretty good, look in decent shape. So now if I turn off this, I'm gonna zoom back out to full, and I'm gonna turn on the red trace now. The red trace is coming from the crankcase, okay? So I've got it in the oil fill tube right now, all right? So I'm just gonna hit process data here. I'm just gonna make this just a little bit bigger. Okay, and now if you look at this, the red trace here, you see that there's a little rise here at every little pulse. Well, that's your pressure in the crankcase. But I'm using the piezo sensor on this, so I'm just looking for a relative change, okay? So if you look at this, they all look pretty relatively even. They look decent. So with this would basically tell me, you know, I don't have any one of these cylinders that has an excessive leak, but that's relatively speaking. Now, if I wanted to know exactly the exact amount of pressure I had, then I would use my inches of water sensor and then measure it, okay? If I had another inch of water sensor, I would be using that too, because it gives me an exact measurement, okay? And that's what I prefer, because then I know how much pressure I have. All right, I'm just showing you it this way so you have an idea of, you know, what to look for, okay? All right, so I'm just gonna multiply this just a little bit more. And then I'm gonna move this up. And now, as you can see here, I've got more distinguished humps right here. So let me just go down just a little bit. And I'm gonna smooth that out just a little bit more. There we go. Now I'm just putting a filter to this. Okay, so if you look at the red trace here, this is showing that the crankcase pressure, and if you look at my starter current here, which is the relative compression, if you notice, if I take my cursors here, okay, you have top dead center compression, then the cylinder fires, and then you get a peak pressure from the crankcase, and if you look at where it's at in relationship to the starter current here, that is showing you that that is happening on your power stroke, okay? Because on the power stroke, you've got pressure pushing down on the piston, and any pressure that leaks by the rings or past the cylinder wall, it's gonna show up as that. So that just proves to everyone that, you know, that's showing the crankcase pressure, okay? So that's how you look at the crankcase pressure and then see how they all look, okay? The level isn't too high, the pressure on this, they all look pretty good, and my intake vents look good as well. So now the last thing I'm gonna show here is the exhaust vents. Then I'm gonna multiply that. And now we have our exhaust vents, okay? So now what I'm gonna do is, to ID exhaust vents, I'm just gonna line up this cursor there and there. I'm gonna hit mark cylinders. I wanna look at exhaust. And now we're looking at all our exhaust events here. Okay, so this is exhaust event 2, 4, 1, 5, 3, 6, okay? Now you can get different software where you can get overlays to tell you what piston event you have. I'm just using this one because it's on the software, okay? But anyway, this is your peak exhaust right here, at three, or top dead center exhaust 360, okay? So, and then another thing is on a six cylinder engine, all of your events, exhaust events, intake events, doesn't matter. When you're looking at it this way, each one is gonna be 120 degrees apart. So if you look at the top here, it says 120 degrees right by my calculator right there, okay? So these are my exhaust events. And as you notice, they all look pretty good, decent shape. And not only that, I can measure how much exhaust I have in there with the pressure transducer, okay? So this is how you would go about doing a cranky mechanical test, okay? So in the next video that I do, I'll do another one where I show you how to check it, you know, while it's running, some of the things that you need to be aware of, okay? But this, in a nutshell, is how you check the rest of the engine mechanical to figure out where exactly your problem lies, okay? So that's about it for today. If you have any questions, just give me a shout out or go to our website, www.training.diesellaptops.com, and I would love to hear from you, okay? So everyone have a good afternoon, and take care. Thank you.